I wonder, do you have a favourite Christmas carol? For me, it is O Little Town of Bethlehem, a favourite I know for many. And there is something in particular about one line that never fails to move me, whatever the setting. Yet in the dark streets shineth the everlasting light. In my cascade of memories across many Christmases, some hard and some more hopeful, I see people wrapped up warm on a wintry evening, making their way along streets that only a few weeks before seemed drab and grey as the evenings were drawing in. Those same streets are now sparkling with lights in windows and on lampposts, and passing through the town or village centre with its proudly decorated Christmas tree, perhaps leaning a little in the wind, they finally join a queue of people of all ages moving with excitement and anticipation through the wide open doors of a candle-lit church. In that place, the most wonderful story of all is told once again in readings, song and prayers about a light that came to shine in the darkness so that dark streets need hold no fears and troubled hearts at the close of another year that has brought unexpected pain and sorrow would find comfort and healing. And a world that has inflicted terrible wounds, leaving yet more scars on the landscape of history, will not finally triumph, because none of these things could ever extinguish the light of the glory of God in the face of Christ. The next line makes sense of it all. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. The sight of the baby in the manger was all the shepherds needed to turn their fearful wonder on a hillside into the boundless joy of that first Christmas. This child would change everything. He is the saviour of the world and the hope of the nations. He is also the Prince of Peace. This year has been so very hard on many levels. War in Ukraine, the death of our beloved Queen Elizabeth II, and the ever-increasing hardship of an economic crisis that many have never known before. It may also have been particularly difficult this year for you on a more personal level, or for someone you know and love. Fear may stalk in the darkness of our sorrow and sadness or our uncertainties about the future, but it need not overwhelm us, because the light of Christ, the everlasting light, shines in the darkness, and his perfect love can cast out all fear. It may be right and necessary to celebrate Christmas more simply this year, but we can still celebrate with all our hearts and focus our best attention on God's story. The story of light over darkness, hope over fear, and love over hate. That's why churches all across the diocese, like this one at St. Mary's in Newark, will open wide their doors as they do all through the year. And everyone will be welcome to wrap up warm, walk along the streets to join in a celebration of the light of Christ that truly makes all the difference in the world. And I hope that perhaps you even get to sing your favourite carol too.